Let me see that map. Alright, so here's Auchentool.
Well, that should be on the right if I remember correctly. And I don't remember correctly.
It is. Oh, and here's Braemore.
Well, that should be on the left.
It is. So, where the heck are we?
Well, what's in the middle?
Nothing.
Well, that must be where we are.
In nothing.
Yeah.
And for a fellow with my potentialities,
this right here is the ideal location. We'll find our way out when the sun comes up.
I'm a couple of game hunters we are. We come out here all the way from New York, and our first night out, we get lost.
Well, maybe we took the high road instead of the low road. Would you like a drink?
No, thanks.
All right, more for me.
Did you tell me you were going to cut down on that stuff?
I did, but I'm a terrible liar. It's okay. I remember once I was going with this wonderful girl, and she would plead with me and plead with me to stop. So, one day I did, but then we figured out we had nothing to talk about, so we broke up.
This forest gives me the feeling of being a cathedral.
It were.
I know where the exit was. You don't believe in anything, do you?
Well, of course I do.
Really? What?
Well, you know, anything that's real to me. Anything I can see, hear, smell, touch, taste, and swallow.
And the things you don't understand?
Dismiss them.
That must make everything very easy, doesn't it?
Comfortable is the word.
I envy you, Jeff.
Why?
You seem to be very satisfied.
I am. Aren't you?
No, I'm not.
Why not? You've got a fine girl, you got a fine job, and right now you're lost in a fine forest. What more could you want?
I don't know, but something seems wrong. Especially about Jane and me. And that makes everything seem wrong. Look how I postponed getting married. I just can't get myself to that altar.
Well, I don't see what could be wrong about it. She's young, attractive, and fits smack into your niche in life. And on top of that, she loves you in just the proper amount, too.
What's the proper amount?
Well, enough to make you happy, but not enough to embarrass your friends.
It looks ideal, doesn't it?
But
why don't I see it? I must be lacking somewhere.
Don't go talking yourself into an inferiority. You don't deserve it.
What do you mean?
Well, all my friends who do have inferiority complexes are absolutely right. They're not as good as everyone else. But someone like you has got the looks. Great job.
Do you hear that?
Thank you. Mother.
I feel so sorry for you.
I know, darling.
aim on this occasion is to be hospitable, not philanthropic.
Isn't the way to go to the house, Mrs. Beaton?
Of course, Miss Fiona.
Good morning, Fiona.
Hello, Meg.
A jug of cake, please. My brother Angus will be glad since the last party for a change.
Why?
When the lads come shopping, they look so handsome. I didn't like to ask him for money.
But you'll never make a profit doing that.
No, but I make a lot of friends. Is this for the wedding tonight?
Aye.
Fiona, what are you going to think about marriage for yourself?
Oh, when I find someone who makes me think of it.
And you have never found anyone up till now who makes you think of it?
No. You see, I didn't want to just get married. I think you should only do it when me and your lad want to stay together fiercely. And getting married is the only way you can do it that's proper.
That's an unusual idea.
Many a lassie, as everyone knows, will try to be married before 25. So she'll agree to most any proposal. All he must be is a man and a wife. I hold a dream that there's no compromising. I know there's one certain laddie for me. One day he'll come walking o'er the horizon by shooting notes, then an
snobbish of you? Why isn't it on the map?
For good and sound reasons.
Well, what is all this? Is this like the day you take pictures for postcards? You mean you always go around with all of these clothes on?
No.
Come on, somebody, anybody, what is this? What's going on here?
We're having a fair.
Oh, is that milk you're selling there?
Aye.
Can we buy some? We're awfully thirsty. We've been walking all night.
I'll have to see your money first.
Now will not see her again, especially not in the glen at 10. For soon across the green, I'll go home with Bonnie Jean.
Go home, go home, go home with Bonnie Jean. Go home, go home.
I'll go home with Bonnie Jean. Hello to Mary Ann, I know I'll soon have a wife and leave yours alone. A Bonnie wife indeed, and she's all I'll ever need. With Bonnie Jean, my days will fly, and love her I will to the day I die. That's why across the green I'll go home with Bonnie Jean.
Go home, go home, go home with Bonnie Jean. Go home.
Lass, this isn't your usual hamlet off the highway either. talking about? Somebody in a miracle?
Oh, that. I'm sorry. I kinda say.
But you said you'd tell me later.
I know, but I kinda say.
That's fine. You know, if I stick around this place long enough, I'll probably find everyone here is slightly nutty. Is that possible?
I kinda say.
Why not?
Because I didn't know what nutty
means. It means slightly insane.
Well then, I can assure you, we're not far from insane. We're a most blessed group of people, and I never realized how fortunate we are until I meet someone from the outside. I mean, a stranger to Brigadoon. I didn't know anything about you, but from the little you've told me, everything you think, I think differently about. And I'm also quite certain that what I think is much more, well, pleasant. And I'm sorry to settle that, but to anger me when you called us insane.
You don't like me very much, do you?
That's the odd part. I like you very much. I just didn't like anything you say.
Fiona.
Hi.
If I stuck around here today, would you take me to the wedding this evening?
Why do you suddenly want to go?
I cannot say.
Well then, I'll say it to you. And I'll be highly pleased to be there.
You will? Why?
Because of what I just told you. I like you very much.
That's right, you did say that, didn't you?
Now I'll take you to a place where you can lie down and rest.
Where are you going?
To gather some heather for the wedding.
Where do you do that?
On the hill.
May
where
I come
the
with
heather
you?
Is. I do it much faster alone, I'm sorry.
But I won't bother you, really. Maybe I'm the one who's a little nutty. But
can't we two go walking together out beyond the valley of trees? Out where there's a hillside of heather, curtsying gently in the breeze. That's what I'd like to do. The heather, but with you. The mist of May is in the gloaming, and all the clouds are holding still. So take my hand and we'll go roaming through the heather on the hill. The morning dew is blinking yonder. There's lazy music in the rill, but all I want to wander through the heather on the hill. There may be other days as rich and rare. There may be other springs as full and fair. But they won't be the same. They'll come and go. For this I know, that when the mist is in the gloaming and all the clouds are holding still, you're not there, I won't go roaming through the heather on the hill. The heather on the hill.
You see? You can say nice things when you want to.
It almost sounded like I was falling in love with you, didn't it?
Oh. There's a difference between falling in love and just being sentimental because you're tired.
Is that what I was being? Sentimental because I'm tired?
I believe so. But 'tis very agreeable.
The mist of May is in the gloaming, and all the clouds are on the tip.
Time to wander through the heather on the hill. There may be other things.
see a young lad like you.
A young lad?
Aye, you're very young.
That is either a deliberate lie or wishful thinking. I'm ancient, decrepit, and disintegrating rapidly. Well, what's under here? Like a rock garden or something?
My father used to sleep on it. He and my mother met in the shed. You see, my mother was a gypsy. Uh-huh. And one day, she was walking past the shed, and she saw my father asleep on the cot. She liked his looks, and she was a wee bit tired anyhow. So she sat on the edge of the bed and waited for him to wake up. And it wasn't long after that I was born.
That's got to be the sweetest bedtime story I've ever heard.
Yeah. You're sure you're comfortable?
Oh, very. Thank you very much. You've been more than kind. Now, if you want to round off your generosity, buzz off.
God, that's a lad.
You should see me when I'm rested. I'm almost robust. Well, you'd better. When I sleep, I make all sorts of odd noises.
Who told you? Do you have a wife?
No, but I was engaged once.
What happened to the last you engaged to?
She fell in love with a Russian.
A Russian? Russia is in Europe, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Just cross the channel and then take a left.
I get a little lad. Right with a lad.
Now look, lass. I'm not sure what you're after, but I don't want to. I want to go to sleep.
But didn't you see? I'm highly attracted to you.
Well, thank you very much. And we'll discuss this whole problem when I wake up. And trust me, you have a problem.
Lying on the cot, I feel a little tadpole jumping on my side.
That's about as repulsive an idea as I've heard in years. You know, if sex were a hobby, you'd be a collector's item. Go!
You men are all alike.
I should certainly hope so.
They're all brutes. You get what you want from a lass and then it's farewell.
Get what I want? But I can't even get you to go away.
That's what I'm referring to. I thought you were interested in me and that's why you let me take you here. You misled me.
You certainly have one hell of an imagination. Can you think of one good reason why I, a strange man, would be interested in you, a strange woman, and at this hour of the day?
Of course I can, because you're a lad and I'm a lass.
That philosophy, you must have had a very provocative career.
I've had a great many heartbreaks.
I don't doubt
it. At 16 years I was blue and sad, and father said I should find a lad, so I set out to become a
thank you.
thought it was a bugle and got up and marched away. Grandpa said, daughter, there must be one, someone who's true but told to run. So I'm still looking to be a one and find a
playing to ease my longing. There's nothing wrong in me. Stop.
got to whisper this softly, for though I'm burning to shout my yearning, for some tiptoeing of me, oh, come to bend to kiss me good day. Darling, my darling, tis all I can say, just come to bend. They've told me I can't behold ye till when music starts playing. To ease my longing, there's nothing wrong in setting out here and saying, oh, come to bed to kiss me good day. Darling, my darling, tis all I can say, just come to me, bend to me, kiss me one day. If
disregard everything about Scottish frugality. Their generosity? Overpowering.
Well, how do you feel?
Surprisingly well. How about you?
I've never felt better in my life.
You too?
Maybe the sun gave me the power, for I could swim Loch Lomond and be home in half an hour. Maybe the air gave me the drive, for I'm all aglow and alive. What a day this has been, what a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why, it's almost like being in love. For the music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel when that bell starts to peal, I could swear I was falling. I could swear I was falling. It's almost like being in love. When we walked up the bridge,
not a word did we say. It was almost like being in love. But
almost like being in love.
All the music of life seems to be
like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel when that bell starts to peal,
Bible here.
there an explanation or isn't there?
Aye, there is, but I can't tell you.
Well, who can? I'd like to know.
We'll have to speak to the Dominie.
The who?
Our schoolmaster, Mrs. Lundy.
Where does she live?
Up the road in a tree.
Mr. Forsythe asked God to make Brigadoon vanish into the Highland Mist.
vanish, but not for always. It would all return just as it were, once every 100 years. The people would go on leading their customary lives, just each morning when they awoke, it would be 100 years later. And the next morning when we awoke, it was 100 years later.
My God.
You see, in this way, Mr. Forsythe knew there would be no change in the lives of the people. They just wouldn't have been any century long enough to be touched by it.
So what you're saying is, when you go to bed at night, and you wake up the next morning, it's 100 years later?
Aye.
So each day is 100 years later?
Aye.
Well, what happened to this minister?
We never saw him again. You see, Mr. Forsythe knew to ask for such a miracle, a sacrifice would have to be made. And he wanted to be the one to make it. Now what would be the greatest sacrifice he could offer? It was to be separated before his time from the ones he loved. So that's why he went out to a hill beyond Brigadoon. Were the miracle granted, he would never see Brigadoon again.
And all this happened 200 years ago.
Aye, lad, which is only 2 days ago to us. Yeah. Mr. Forsythe intended to ask for the miracle on Tuesday, but Charles Dalrymple was in school in Edinburgh, and he wasn't expected back till Tuesday late. Not wanting anything to go wrong with the wedding, he postponed praying until Charlie got back.
Wasn't that sweet of him?
Suppose someone here got fed up and decided to leave, would they?
Oh, no, lad. Can I leave?
Wait a minute. Do I have to stay here now?
No, lad. But if anyone of Brigadoon leaves, the enchantment is broken for all.
And
that night when the people go to sleep, Brigadoon will disappear forever.
Look, I'm not saying I believe all this, but suppose a stranger to Brigadoon, like me, came and wanted to stay. Could he?
Aye, lad, he could. Mr. Forsythe provided for that.
He didn't miss a trick.
No, lad, he didn't. A stranger can stay if he loves someone here, not just Brigadoon, mind you, but someone in Brigadoon enough to want to stay here and leave everything behind, which is how it should be. Because after all, lad, if you love someone deeply, anything is possible.
I think I like that part best.
Shouldn't you be thinking about helping Jeannie with the wedding?
I had. Tommy, will I see you later?
Yes, I'll be here.
Thank you, Tommy. I must be going. Thank you, Mrs. Lindy.
She's a dear lass.
I'm finding that out. Tell me, Mrs. Lindy, you're all perfectly happy living in this here town?
Of course, lad. After all, sunshine can peep through a small hole.
But when you go to bed at night, what is it like?
Well, for me, it's just like being carried on shadowy arms to some far-off cloud, and there I float till morning. And yet sometimes I think I hear strange voices.
Voices?
Aye. They say no words I can remember, but their voices fill with a fearful longing, and sometimes they seem to be calling me back. There must be lots of folk out there who'd like to bring it in. Oh, 'tis the wedding time.
Thank you.
All I've done is want you too much. I'm leaving Brigadoon. He's the end of all of us. The miracle is over.
God here has said. Don't tell the rest till tomorrow that Harry is dead. They'll find he's dead tomorrow. Tell them.
I thought to myself with a sigh.
it.
I wanted to hear you say it, even though it'd be at the last minute like this.
Last minute?
I soon out is the end of our date.
And then you vanish?
Yes.
Fiona, I can't leave you. Not now, I can't. Wait a minute. Didn't Mrs. Lundy say that someone could stay if he loved someone enough? Well, that's for me. Where do I go? Who do I talk to? Where do I get a passport to disappear?
Oh, tell me, darling. We must go see Mrs. Lundy.
I can't be without you now, Fiona. I'd be afraid to be.
Hey! You shouldn't feel too ashamed of yourself, Tommy. Just the hardest thing in the world to give everything. even though it is usually the only way to get everything.
Do you understand it all?
Mother used to make. Give me some gin. And what will you have with it, sir?
A little bourbon.
Say, what time is it? I think I lost my watch. Well, it's about 6:10.
I better be getting home.
It's just about time Miss Ashton called.
Who?
Jane Ashton. Mr. Albright's fiancée. Don't tell me you don't remember her.
All right, I won't. What about her?
Well, it's either about this time every day she either calls or comes in, or both, looking for Mr. Albright.
She does, eh?
And from what I gather, she can't find him.
Well, I'm glad you warned me. I'll drink up and get out of here.
Don't you like Miss Ashton, sir?
Oh, very much. Just not when she's stalking Mr. Albright. I tell you, Frank, you can scratch the surface of any woman, and she'll enjoy it.
Well, where's Mr. Albright anyhow?
I don't know. About a month ago, he quit his job, packed up his parcels, and vanished like Brigadoon.
Like who?
The name of my brother who ran away.
Hello.
Oh, Mr. Albright, it's
Dobby,
nice to see you.
My old friend, Dobby. Tommy's back.
Yeah.
Well, where you been all month?
Up on a farm in New Hampshire.
Farm? What are you messing around with all that dirty dirt and stuff? What are you doing up there?
Enjoying myself. Ryan soda, please, Frank.
Well, if that's what you like, when you get married, you should buy one.
I wonder if I want to get married, Jeff.
Why?
Because, my dear old tank, I'm in love with someone else, and I cannot get over it. Because I can't be with her, I can't be with anyone else. That's why I went away. So many things remind me of her. When I'm with people and they're talking to me, I might just say one little word that will open a door to a memory for me. Suddenly, I'm thousands of miles away, there, with her. Slowly, I drift back to the conversation. They ask me a question, and I don't know what the heck they're talking about. I haven't heard a word.
You, my friend, must be fascinating company.
It's easier when I'm alone.
Tommy!
Jane!
What a wonderful surprise!
Hello, Jane!
When did you get back?
Hello, Jeff!
Just a little while ago. Well, hi, Jane. How are you?
I've been worried about the death of you.
I'm fine. How are you?
Oh, you know, I got a little cold. But other than that...
I must say, you do look wonderful.
So do you, Jane.
Well, I don't want to eat and run, but I think I'll head up to my room and have a drink.
I'll see you later, Jeff.
Hello.
Goodbye. Put on the bill, Frank.
Your bill, sir, is... awfully high.
So am I.
Tommy, what did you write me?
Nothing to say, I guess. Drink?
Old fashioned, please, Frank. And why didn't you wire me you were coming in? After all, darling, I didn't think a minute you'd get into town, you'd call me, or come to me, or in fact.
Interested in everybody we know either.
You You've certainly been antisocial since your return from Scotland. If you really want to avoid everybody, why don't we take Mr. Jackson's house? It's far away and right on top of a high, beautiful hill.
But when the mist is in the gloom,
difference between you and I.
tell me about it. I find that sometimes what you believe in can become more real to you than anything you can ever explain away or understand. God, why do people have to lose things just to find out what they need?
Well, take one last look and start walking. I got lost around here once.
Okay.